Let's talk about tremor and the types of tremor. Tremor is a rhythmical movement of a part of the body, usually due to alternating activation of the agonist muscle and the antagonist muscle. There are five common types of tremor: physiologic tremor, essential tremor, Parkinsonian tremor, dystonic tremor, and the last one is functional tremor. So let's try to differentiate between those different version or types of tremor. Starting from the physiologic tremor, usually the physiologic tremor involves arms more than the legs. It's commonly seen with movement. It has a high frequency. Obviously, that makes the amplitude very low. High frequency means low amplitude. And physiologic tremor is commonly seen during anxiety or after taking drugs. Essential tremor has features almost similar to the physiologic tremor, but essential tremor commonly involves the arm and the head. The difference between physiologic tremor and essential tremor is presence of family history and reduction of the tremor by using alcohol. Those two will help to differentiate between essential tremor and physiologic tremor. Physiologic tremor occurs with anxiety and drugs. Essential tremor is relieved by alcohol. Those features will differentiate, but the frequency and amplitude of both of them are similar. In Parkinsonism, the tremor is usually unilateral and asymmetrical, involving one limb in the initial stages. And arms are more involved than the legs. Compared to the physiologic and essential tremor, which occur in movement, Parkinsonian tremor usually occur at rest. Also, Parkinson tremor has a low frequency. Physiologic and essential tremor has high frequency, but Parkinsonian tremor has a low frequency. That means the amplitude will be high. And the typical character of Parkinsonian tremor is a peel rolling tremor. In dystonia, the tremor can involve the head, arms, or legs. It usually occurs in a specific posture, and the frequency amplitude are variable, and there may be other features of dystonia. In functional tremor, which is not really a tremor, which is like distractible, when you distract the patient, the tremor just vanishes. In functional tremor, there can be tremor in any part of the body, in any position, and the frequency amplitude are not fixed. They can go up and down. So that's everything you need to know to differentiate between varieties of tremor. Thanks a lot for watching the videos. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the like button.